treatment post progression on osimertinib is the big question mark. We currently don't have any therapies approved post osimertinib, and my recommendation is a clinical trial. There are several overriding mechanisms that are potentially actionable: MET amplification, BRAF activation, have an overdrive of the EGFR receptor itself. In the end, those are very difficult assays to run. They require tissue, they require gene expression profiles, if they're not identified by simple mutations. But we know that the post-osimertinib resistance pattern is much more heterogeneous compared to the post-first and second generation TKIs with the predominant T790M development. So my recommendation right now is a clinical trial. In my practice, if a patient does not match clinical trial criteria, again, the Empower 150 regimen is going to be my preferred therapy of choice. Rebiopsy is a concept that has been used in breast cancer for 20 years. In lung cancer, this is a concept that has been established. We've been having an approval for second-line molecular markers for osimertinib for several years now, but it really hasn't been used as stringently as it should have been. So I do recommend rebiopsying of growing tissue lesions. I think this is critical, including an RNA-based sequencing profile to look for potential gene expression profile changes that may explain progression. I don't think that it is reasonable to fly blind. There's clearly a change in the disease, clearly a change in the biological behavior that probably results in changes in gene expression or potentially in gene mutations. So understanding these changes is critical in guiding the patient's therapy. The idea of targeted therapy and personalized medicine is to go by these molecular changes and not necessarily to rely on plumb sequences of individual treatment regimens. Liquid biopsy is an option in non-small cell lung cancer upon progression. It obviously only captures DNA changes. It will probably miss the majority of overriding mechanisms in the post-osimertinib setting. I think in the absence of an available tissue biopsy, or if the patient is uncomfortable with additional invasive procedures, I believe it is, if it's a reasonable option, I think it carries a reasonable sensitivity and is certainly a procedure in which the patient is subjected to very little downsides. So I think it is reasonable in the absence of tissue availability, but tissue has the ability to look at RNA, has the ability to look at additional markers in the setting, reconfirm the diagnosis. There's some heterogeneity. You can have obviously multiple clones that may be growing. So my recommendation would be to target the growing lesions of concern with a directed tissue biopsy.